will never be the same.
Beloved, we welcome you to another exciting, wonderful edition of the Voice of Resurrection. I'm just teaching you things as revealed to me by the Holy Spirit, how we must fast from our desires, our needs, our wrong focus, to come back to what the Lord has promised, to come back to what the Lord has ordained, so that the glory will rest upon us in this season of grace. The disciples asked Jesus a question in verse 6 of Acts chapter 1. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him. In other words, this was a collegiate question. They all felt the same way. They all had the same expectation. It's amazing how we are always thinking of one thing when God is really after another. And it takes the Holy Spirit to connect the two. Otherwise, we will always remain off track with the Lord. Somebody said, yeah, I know, that's where I am. I just heard you. You're a lady. Yes, then abandon what it is you're talking about and just come back to the Lord and begin to seek the Lord. It's a slow process. Don't expect magic. But things will come around if you stay with it. Amen? Amen. All right? He says, Lord, will thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? Listen to his answer. We want to dwell on that today. And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons. One of my ministers pointed out to me that he hadn't noticed the issue of times. He always thought about time and seasons. No, times. There are times in the calendar of God. Then there are seasons. The summation of time produces a season. You see? There are times. There's a time, the Bible said, to be born, a time to weep, a time to mourn, time. When you sum them all up, the times. But in all those times, God remains God. He says, it's not for you to know those times. It's not for you to know the seasons. The time is when God is ready to do something. The season is while he's doing it. It's periodic. It's a span. Time is the moment, the fulfillment. When you come into it, when it happens, it's time for my breakthrough. When the breakthrough will start. But the times, we have entered into a dynamic flow where things are happening, popping on all cylinders. You see? It says, it's not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father, watch this, hath put in his own power. So what changes times? God's power. What changes seasons? God's power. But he says, you don't ask such questions. When are you going to do this? When are you going to do that? Consecration, beloved. Departing from stress is consecration. Stopping to worry is consecration. Going to sleep is consecration. Don't just think about the physical sins. Think about the consecration of your heart and mind to God that will generate the power and the miracles necessary to birth your breakthrough and this season of double fruitfulness. Some say it's year of jubilation. Some say it's year of blessing and bountiful blessings and miracles. Some say it's year of jubilee. Some say all kinds of things. But beloved, no matter what year is pronounced in your domain of worship, remember, except the standards of the Lord are met, nothing will happen. It's not for you to know the times all the seasons. You see? So then don't worry about it. Stop stressing about it. Don't get ulcers thinking about it. Allow the process of God to just work the way He has ordained it. That's the way you serve God. You see, it says, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father had put in His own power. So God sees things happening, but He ordained that, all right, this will happen June 2015. It doesn't matter what goes on. It will not going to happen before then. That's why you learn to hold on and have faith. Because that's a time, and there are times, and that's a season, and there are seasons. You see? And He said He put it in His own power. Beloved, the good news is, it doesn't matter what the enemy has been accomplishing. Once the time comes, the power of God will enter in and change everything. The power of God will enter in and change everything. That's the point of it all. May God help you with the grace to manage your frustrations properly until the power of God visits. We have areas where things are happening. We really desire something to happen. The Lord hasn't said anything. And we don't pressure Him. We just continue to serve Him every day, worship Him, and listen to Him. And then one day He will just tell us, all right, do this. It will come because that's His way. He said, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Isaiah 66 says, I had not seen, neither had entered the heart of man, what the Lord had prepared, O Lord, for them that wait for Him. In Philippians 2, He said, them that seek Him or love Him. Here in Isaiah 66, He said, them that wait for Him. You see? May God bring to pass the glory of resurrection, the power and the glory and the miracle He has promised us in this season of 2015. Remember, He is faithful that promised. I didn't make these promises. You didn't either. God made them. He loved us when we didn't love Him. He died for us through Jesus when we were His enemies. He has proven His promises. Remember that the elders died not receiving it, but yet were persuaded. And the Bible says, because God prepared better things for us. May we recognize that the miracle is now, the victory is now, as we consecrate ourselves. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Yes, he is.